Assalamu alaikum. We will start my lecture concerning ECMO in COVID-19. At the end of the lecture, we should know what is the ECMO and its basic indication for ECMO in COVID-19 patient, complication of ECMO, using ECMO or not. Let's start with some terms regarding ECMO. Extracorporeal life support, which means ECMO inserted during CPR. ECMO, extracorporeal membrane oxygenation, which is used, veno-arterial ECMO for cardiac support, and veno-venous ECMO for respiratory support. Another new modality, which is extracorporeal carbon dioxide removal, which need less cannula size and less flow. ECMO for respiratory support is veno-venous ECMO, which is the target of our lecture today. Physiologic function. The ECMO act as artificial lung replace the human lung, so oxygen delivery to meet the metabolic need and removal of CO2. Here the diagram represents how veno-venous ECMO work. So the deoxygenated blood from the patient taken go to the membrane, which is act as the artificial lung, then the oxygenated blood back to the patient bypassing the human lung. This picture is a real example for how ECMO machine looks beside the patient. The upper part of the picture is a pump, and the lower part is a membrane which acts as an artificial lung. Here, two different types of cannulation in veno-venous ECMO. The first one is internal jugular cannulation, which is through a balloon cannula. So the idea is the same like hemodialysis catheter. We have two ports, one for deoxygenated blood from the patient to the membrane, and the other port to return back the oxygenated blood to the patient. In this modality, the patient has ability to be ambulated, maybe walking while he is in ECMO, and it is very good in handling the patient. The only issue, it's not suitable for the patient who had high body mass index, and it's very expensive. The other types of cannulation is to put the drainage cannula in femoral vein and the inflow cannula in internal jugular. Sometimes we can put two femoral veins cannula, one for drainage and the other for the inflow cannula, and not using the internal jugular. The first function of ECMO is oxygenation. So oxygenation in ECMO is depending on FiO2 for an ECMO site, membrane capacity, red cell exposure and gas exchange area, hemoglobin and the blood flow. The second function of artificial lung is CO2 removal, which depends merely on gas flow rate called sweep flow, not depend too much on the blood flow. We should note that. Ventilation during ECMO should be in resting mode. This is allow the lung for rapid recovery. Any change in blood gases or dealing with blood gases should be through the ECMO site, not the ventilator site. At the support of the minimal rule of ventilation during ECMO, this is patient from China, 8 years old with COVID-19, who is extubated and she is able to communicate while she is in ECMO. As we mentioned before, any change in blood gas while the patient is in ECMO will be from the ECMO side, not from the ventilation. So, ESO guidelines recommended to put the patient on resting mode of ventilation and allowing spontaneous breath. Many studies support this also, like Kiran et al. They support spontaneous breathing during ECMO, and some goes further besides the spontaneous breathing. They also recommend, like Lorenzo et al., for international ECMO network, they recommend to limit the driving pressure during ventilation on ECMO. And this is will decrease the shearing stress on the lung, allowing lung resting and decrease the release of the inflammatory mediators. As a part of this disease, there was a debate regarding using ECMO or not using ECMO as any medical treatment in this disease. So this is literature review from China, which is summarize the indication of using ECMO in COVID-19 patients. before jumping to ECMO, which is in the top of the pyramids, we should go for other modalities for treatment of ERDS, like lung protective strategy, high beep, neuromuscular blockade, prone position, we use high frequency ventilation, nitric oxide, then the ECMO. This is like simple cases of ERDS patient. This is the steps we should follow for each patient. Indication of ECMO in COVID-19 patient after fulfill all other therapy based on the entry from criteria from AEOLIA trial. So the patient will be on high ventilatory setting and the following is BO2 FiO2 ratio less than 15 millimeter mercury for 3 hours or BO2 FiO2 less than 80 millimeter mercury for 6 hours or the pH less than 7.25 with PCO2 more than 60 millimeter mercury for 6 hours with respiratory rate increased to reach 35 breaths per minute to adjust plateau pressure less than 32 centimeter water. Besides the indication before, the patient should have another additional selection criteria, mechanical ventilation days less than 7 days, age less than 65 years old, only single organs function, presence of well-trained staff. And this is for ELSO guidelines, recommended that center should have 50 cases per year to receive ECMO for COVID-19 patient. As any treatment, ECMO has side effect, maybe related to the ECMO circuit itself, which like oxygenator failure, blood clot in the oxygenator, blood clot in the cannula, cannula-related problem like improper choice of cannula size, improper position of the cannula, bleeding at the cannula site. Other mechanical problems like pump failure, not related to the ECMO circuit itself, like bleeding due to using of anticoagulation, GIT bleeding, hemolysis may occur from high speed of the pump, disseminated intravascular coagulation may be due to consumption of coagulation factor. This case from France, which show rare complication presence of DVT at cannulation site, which may be related to hypercoagulable state of COVID-19. As a part of the debate of using ECMO in COVID-19 or not using ECMO in COVID-19, ELSO released a registry recently, which has data for 1,035 patients with COVID-19 who received ECMO support included in this study. And they found that in hospital mortality days after ECMO initiation was 38, which is constant with the previous mortality rate in non-COVID-19 ECMO-supported patient. Zhuzhang and Etel released some data from UK as a case series for using of venous ECMO in COVID-19 patient. 43 patients total received ECMO, 29 of the patients are survival and the rest are non-survival. My last word is, using ECMO or not using the ECMO, that is not our question. The ECMO sometimes will be the last modality for the patient. But when to use, when the patient fulfills the criteria, where to use, when we have a highly equipped center, highly trained staff, the ECMO would be a good choice. Thank you for your time. I'm ready for your question.